Thanksgiving the day after. Thank you for liberty as license in excess to make us fat and stupid. Like turkeys portrayed as what they are not, but they taste sweet, like the memory of what we lost. God bless us for being a nation of assholes in every country where they don't celebrate what we have lied ourselves into believing was representative of our gratitude. Where irony is, the cranberry sauce and the gravy lines the arteries of our superhighways. In the portable mashed potatoes of wide load bodies yearning to be free. Where our children are pierced with navel rings and tongue studs, the one hidden in folds of flesh and the other hardening daddy's fat cock, while mom cruises the aisles of the open 24 hours giant supermarket in a Valium haze, searching. I've been searching. I've been searching every day and generating vipers like the Bible in hip-hop done by Snoop Dogg and dressed by Diddy. And available in Spanish and Braille for those who need to touch what they can't feel. And joined at the hip to the country we fought to achieve independence from, who never stopped running the show and who joins us now in another nation where death is the technicolored dream coat. And we like it better from behind, with a reach around, than we do on our backs and looking into the face of the rapist, who made sure that the only people walking on the Sea of Galilee are Palestinians running too fast to sink. Yeah. I got your gratitude swinging. I got your illuminated text and the bloated bodies that Rooney might have mentioned if he had been Nostradamus instead. Or Nosferatu in the White House where they don't get mentioned. We hold these truths to be. We hold these dark woods and serial killer drop zones in the ice plants along the sides of California freeways to be self-evident. I wish I had a country to love. I wish I hadn't died in the loading zone. I wish I had not shit in one hand and wished in the other. I wish. We thank you, Lord, for these blessings we're about to conceive. Indivisible, with no kind of fucking justice, in thrall to the homeland security pigs in the hall. There was another Thanksgiving that wasn't on Thanksgiving, when my mom made me hot dogs because the chili the family was having for dinner on the night I got back from hospital was too spicy for my 12-year-old stomach also. That I got because someone was so angry and cruel that I burned my insides out. I lost it for a while before I even knew it was there. My health, my life, my heart broken inside. I cried. I wept. My father called me a special privileged character. He whipped me like a dog. That's what I got for Thanksgiving. That's what I got. That's what I got for Thanksgiving every day. And he was a soldier for life in the army that protected the land of fat blessings. For which Thanksgiving is the day before shopping is celebrated, and the day after the 2-day wait to shop. Suffering and succotash. Cartoons and life. Animated characters popping out of the sidewalk. One of these days. Ba-ba, ba-da-ba, ba-da-bing. That's all, folks. Cartoon spirals suck back into the real spiral. Buddha, 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 said the machine gun scream. Down on your knees. Good grief. It's Daddy. For these gifts we're about to receive from a god that looks like John Wayne Gacy in a clown suit on a bed of clouds with handcuffs. Thanksgiving. We thank you, God, for the rain of fire that we richly deserve. More for the fundies and the missionaries than we do for the porn. What does it take to paint sugar water under the eyes of starving black children for photo ops in a Banana Republic safari suit? The same thing it takes to be in charge of the exploited children. The same kind of photo op of men congratulating themselves for killing 500,000 people so that their buddies in supply and demand can make enough weapons to defend the bottom line. I am thankful on Thanksgiving that I am not you, and grief-stricken too that you are a part of me. Here in the pumpkin pie wilderness. Of the land of the free.